Greetings everybody from the rather wintry city of Almere in the Netherlands. We are Zo.o guitar duo. Next to me is Marion Schaap, and my name is Peter Constant. Thank you for tuning in, and thank you our dear friend Mesut, and to all his team of the Miami International Guitar Festival for providing this opportunity for us to present our music to you on some of these beautiful instruments.
And we're going to play some beautiful music for you today, written and inspired by women, starting with a lyrical sonnet by the Russian composer Nadia Borislova.
The Italian Baroque composer Domenico Scarlatti, as a young man in his early 30s, already very established as a composer, embarked on a journey throughout Europe to further his career and fortunes. He found himself in the employment in Portugal of a Portuguese princess, Maria Magdalena Barbara was her name. Maria Magdalena, actually, she later married into the Spanish royal family and, in fact, later became Queen of Spain. In all of these years, she insisted that Scarlatti would be with her as her musical tutor and court musician. So for much of Scarlatti's artistic life, he was in the employment and patronage of Maria Magdalena Barbara. Very important because in that role he had the freedom to explore his own musical identity, innovation, in particular in the sonata form, the single movement sonata form that we know so well from him. Eventually he wrote 555 of these sonatas, which as a body of work very well demonstrate the transition from the Baroque dance forms, binary dance forms, into the early classical sonata. Very often we hear the Spanish flavor in the music, which means that the sonatas of Scarlatti very often translate very well from the keyboard onto the guitar. We're going to play two sonatas by Scarlatti. First of all, number 466, a rather mature sonata, which very much looks forward into the new style, into the classical period and beyond. That's the first one we're going to play, and then I use this beautiful baritone guitar. The second sonata we're playing is a rather early sonata, number 54, and in that sonata we hear the old Baroque dance forms coming to the fore. It's a jig, as you'll hear. Thank you.
Dutch composer Annette Kruisbrink wrote this set of dances for her to play with her brother, who happens to be a double bass player. Peter plays it on this stunning bass guitar, which was also built by Graham Caldersmith. These dances, they're contrasting pieces in style and mood. The first one is strongly driven by rhythmic riffs. Sometimes it actually sounds like brother and sister are fighting with each other, like they're out of sync or like something is going horribly wrong. The second one is in a French mood and is an homage to Eric Satie. The last dance has a fast and flowing character and gives the impression of a smooth, calm surface, while at the same time a lot of hard work happens underneath.
Thank you.
Over the last few years, there's been a rapidly increasing interest in the composer Ferdinand Rebay. That's not surprising because he was a highly capable composer who wrote many hundreds of works for the guitar, including a number of large-scale chamber music works in the late Romantic style, which for guitarists has been rather a hole in the repertoire up until now. He wasn't a guitarist, so he needed help, and help was at hand in the form of his niece, Gerta Hammerschmidt. He wrote many, many pieces for her, interestingly enough, especially in the rather difficult years of the Second World War, very affectionately dedicated to her, including the piece that we're going to play. It's the central movement of a very large work, a Grosses Duo, originally written for this wonderful combination of baritone guitar and normal guitar. This middle movement we're going to play is a set of variations on a song, Morgengruss, or Morning Greeting, by Franz Schubert. Franz Schubert was Rebay's great musical hero. Thank you.
Well, French guitarist Ida Presti was widely known for her great virtuosity and expressiveness. She also composed quite a number of works for solo guitar as well as guitar duo. Danse da Vila gives us an impression of various scenes in a small village in the north of Spain. So you'll hear leaves rustling in the wind, or children playing in the sun, passion between lovers, and a stately procession towards the end.
Thank you.
continue our program with a set of delicious Venezuelan pieces. Many are originally solo pieces, you probably know them, which Peter has enriched with the second guitar part, using mostly this lovely little octave guitar. for me personally, it's very special to play this music. As a young girl, I lived in Venezuela for a couple of years with my family, and we all lost our hearts to this warm and vibrant music, which played an important role in our lives ever since.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much for being here with us today. We hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. We have one more little something for you. Emily's Song. It's a short, sweet piece that Australian composer Ross Edwards wrote for his own daughter, Emily, who used to play it on the piano. Bye-bye.